Let me help, said Cassandra kindly, bending down and lifting the animal into her arms. Within moments, she'd safely deposited it onto dry land. Zia arrived soon after, followed by two moles, a family of rabbits, three field mice, and a hedgehog. The animals kept on coming, some paddling on logs across the water. Cassandra and Zia looked around. There were no trees on the island, just thick grass to sit on, surrounded by inky blue water. The wide night sky stretched above them, gently lit by a faint glow of orange from the eclipse of the moon. They couldn't think of a more perfect place to enjoy their midnight feast. Cassandra set the rucksack down and everyone helped unload the feast provisions. The grass was soft as a blanket, and Zia was just adding Thunder's biscuits to the impressive-looking collection of treats when they heard voices from across the water. They turned to see a large fluffy cat leaping nimbly across the stones, followed by Katie and Luca, shouting and waving their arms. You made it! Cassandra and Zia cried in unison. It felt like a lifetime since they'd all been together. They charged over and gathered their friends in the biggest group hug. Did you meet the foxes? Asked Zia when the hug fell apart. Are they going to let us have our feast in peace? Asked Cassandra. But it was impossible to hear their answers because a rumble echoed all around them, gradually getting louder like an orchestra's crescendo. Through the darkness, across lake and sky, throngs of forest creatures were hurrying towards them. There were herds of deer clattering across the stones, bats and birds of prey swooping down from the sky. There were robins and sparrows and other birds they recognised from their gardens. Squirrels and field mice and badgers and voles.